Welcome to WHS News. I'm Austin.
Aloha, and I'm Victor. Please pause for a moment of silence. Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Seniors, you have till 9:30 today to turn in your graduation forms and senior fees to Ms. McKenzie in the library.
Anyone interested in wrestling, please see Coach Crunkleton in room C11.
Powder puff players are still needed. Please have a physical and $20. See Ms. Park in room A10.
Any females interested in trying out for varsity or JV basketball, please pick up a tryout form in the front office or gym. Tryouts will be held today in the old gym at 3:30. Students, if you want to travel to Rome, come see Mr. Porter in room C13. Come with us to Italy. Not with us, but, you know, Mr. Porter. 2016 sport guides are on sale in the office for $10.
Checkout notes must be in the office by 8 a.m. ASVAB testing is October 6th from 8 a.m. to 12. All 12th, 11th, and 10th graders can take the test. Deadline to sign up is September 30th. Come to room E9 to sign up.
That's all for your morning announcements, and now on to WHS Discovery.
Aloha everyone, and welcome to WHS Discovery. I'm Monty.
And I'm Lauren. Today we are headed to Hawaii. Hawaii is one of the world's most largest volcanoes and notorious black sand beaches. Here in Hawaii is a go-to place for tourism and locals to keep the island alive and busy. The island consists of helicopter rides, surfing, nice hotels, and all homeless people.
Hawaii is approximately 10,000 square miles and it has about 187,000 people living in residential and suburban areas. Hawaii was discovered in 1795, and this is definitely going to be your go-to place for tourism. Sounds like we're going to make us a trip.
Yeah, how much are the tickets?
I heard they're around $1,000.
Oh, no biggie. Well, I guess we'll see you on WHS Discovery next week. I'm Lauren.
And I'm Monty.
Welcome to Sports Talk. I'm Macy.
And I'm Mark. Thank you for coming out to support our cross-country team last Saturday.
And thank you for supporting our 9th grade football team against Stanhope. Our varsity football team will have an away game tomorrow night against Chilton County.
Our athlete of the week is Michael. Here's our interview with him.
What's up, Wetumpka? I'm Shay here with our athlete of the week, Michael. So how are you?
Hey, I'm good. Thanks for having me.
So how's football going?
It's going good. We have a great team. We're really close, and we really like to practice and get out there and compete for you guys.
So what did you think about the Chilton?
I thought we had a solid game plan going in. We didn't execute as well as we'd like to the first half. We got down, but we came out the second half really strong. Unfortunately, it wasn't enough to come back and win the game. We had an opportunity to win it at the end, but we came a little short.
Okay. So how does it feel to be a senior on the team?
It feels great. You know, you have a lot of seniorities that are given to you that aren't given to you as an underclassman. But then it's a little different treatment than the coaches, from the coaches, I mean. But, you know, it's great overall.
So what are the goals the team has set to accomplish throughout the rest of the season?
Well, obviously our long-term goal is to win the state championship in Jordan-Hare Stadium. But, you know, we're really working towards being more of a unit and having the brotherhood. And I think that we've done an excellent job of doing that already throughout the season. You know, just to go out every week and compete and give it our all.
Great. Well, thanks for the interview, Michael.
Night of the Bands begins at 6 p.m. tonight at Stanhope Elmore High School. Admission is $7. Children ages 6 and under get in free.
Well, that's all for Sports Talk today.
Hello, Wetumpka. Welcome to Inspiring Indians. I'm Jamaris.
And I'm Riley.
First up is our Teacher of the Week interview, Sergeant Hunter. Hi, we're here with our Teacher of the Week, Sergeant Hunter. How you doing, Sergeant Hunter?
Good morning.
Ms. Sergeant Hunter, how long have you been teaching here?
22 years.
Wow, that's a really long time. Sergeant Hunter, I see you got the Class Act Award. How do you feel about that?
Well, I feel really good about it. I mean, I think it's a great accomplishment. Nothing that I was looking forward to, but to be recognized for, you know, the work that you've done, I think that's very important, and I think that means, you know, a lot, and I really feel honored.
Do you feel that your work that you've done here has been appreciated and achieved?
Well, receiving an award, I think, is sort of speaks for itself, so I really do feel that way, yes.
Okay, do you plan on retiring anytime soon?
Well, you know, for as long as, you know, I can hang in here and as long as my health is good, I plan on staying for a few more years.
All right, that's our Teacher of the Week, Sergeant Hunter.
Now here's our interview with the Senior of the Week, Janelle.
Hello, Wetumpka High School. This is our interview with the senior of the week, Janelle. So what's your favorite part about this high school?
My favorite thing about Wetumpka High School is band and JROTC.
And are you planning to go into college?
Yes.
To which college do you want to go to?
I plan on going to Marion Military Institute.
And who has influenced you to go to that college?
The person that has influenced me to go to this college is my dad.
So that was our interview with the senior of the week, Janelle.
Thank you guys for watching. Up next is entertainment.
And now for some jokes. What do you call a mountain of cats?
I don't know, dude.
A meowtin.
Makes sense.
Okay, so listen, I'm a singer. You know that, right?
I know that.
Okay, well, you know, I'm just, you know, just singing in the shower, having a good time, you know, just everything. But I'm telling you this, okay? It's all good, but it's no fun whenever you get soap in your mouth. You go directly from singing pop music to a soap opera, just like that. It is not fun.
Did you hear the story on the news the other day?
No, I didn't. What happened?
Well, this dude got hit in the head with a 7-Up can, and nobody knows what happened.
Well, is he okay? Because, you know, that could really, it could really hurt.
I know, but it was just a soft drink. He's okay.
Okay. Because that's very bad. But, well, that's all the jokes that we have in entertainment for today. But before y'all go, enjoy this short clip of dogs who think they can talk.
Food. You know, I just couldn't stop thinking about it.
So, yeah.
So, you know, I went to the fridge, and I opened up the meat drawer. You know what the meat drawer is, right?
Yeah. What was in there?
Well, I'll tell you what was in there. You know that bacon that's like maple? It's got maple flavor.
The maple kind, yeah.
Yeah, so...
Yeah?
I took that out, and I thought...
Yeah?
I know who would like that. Me! So I ate it.
Oh! No! You're kidding me.
Nope. Not kidding. You know, I also noticed there was some beef in there. Yeah, you know, steak, you know, juicy. Well, I ate that too. But I went back to the fridge just a few minutes ago, and I put something together really special. You're going to love this one. I took some chicken.
Yeah.
I put some cheese on it, and I... Covered it with what? I covered it with cat treats.
Yeah.
Then guess what?
What?
I gave it to the cat.
And that's all for entertainment. Thank you for watching. Join us again next week and stay tuned for an animation from Mark.